Intestinal bacterial fermentations. What are they?
In short, bacterial fermentation is simply the conversion of carbohydrate into fat. In this case, a specific fatty acid called butyric acid found in butter.
Bacteria feed on what we eat. So there's the feed in the food. Now, unless you've gone through several rounds of antibiotics, that means you have plenty of bacteria in your gut, generally speaking. But if you have gone through several rounds of antibiotics, that means your gut bacteria have been killed off, or a significant number of them have, and you would be helped by eating the bacteria directly, which means eating probiotics. There are different strains of probiotics that feed on sugars, but they produce different outcomes, which mean different acids. Now, the rumen in a cow comes before their stomach, and they have certain bacteria that can convert cellulose or fiber into
butyric acid, one of the antimicrobial fatty acids that's produced when carbs ferment to fat. So ruminants have a rumen, where the bacteria converts sugar or carbs to short-chain fatty acids. This provides the energy for the cow, not the actual food it eats, but the products of fermentation. Even though humans don't have a rumen, we produce the same acids, but in different degrees and in different amounts. Here you see acetic, propionic, and butyric acid, and lactic acid, and a few other products. These are antimicrobial fatty acids you see on the left.
What do I mean by antimicrobial? Well, you hear, or maybe you have heard, that 80% of the immune system is in the gut. Well, it's not the bacteria per se. It's the outcome, which are the acids, which themselves inhibit sensitive pathogens. And since they're acids, they lower the pH and improve mineral absorption to boot. our small intestine, those fermentation reactions are equal to what is happening. Here we see a student's drawing in a class. A student's drawing. If you noticed, they labeled this the bacterial region, the cytosol. That's where the fermentation occurs. That's where lactic acid occurs as we exercise. Just start moving around quickly.